we saw a part of this show today, actually, in this extraordinary hearing in Michigan where a federal judge is now considering sanctions against all of the Trump lawyers who were involved in the Michigan litigation that would ban them from ever practicing law in Michigan again. You have passages in your book about how Donald Trump picks up these kinds of lawyers. You talk about him actually randomly asking people, do you know any good lawyers? I won't quote the book. The passages are extraordinary when you read them. But he's just kind of wandering around asking people about lawyers.
And it's important to note that he actually has good lawyers. There are good lawyers in the White House. There are good lawyers on the campaign. And they refuse to have anything to do with this. So he has to go out and find the only lawyers that he can find who will do this are, along with Rudy Giuliani, completely marginal, completely out there, opportunists at a degree that no longer makes them in anyone's mind serious lawyers. I mean, this is, to put it mildly, the gang that couldn't shoot straight.
Former President Trump is now under criminal investigation by a criminal grand jury in Fulton County, Georgia, for the phone call that he made to the Georgia Secretary of State, a phone call that we've all heard the tape of. We know what the grand jury is considering. You have reporting that he made more phone calls than that, including going around the attorney general and making phone calls directly to U.S. attorneys around the country. Is there any possibility we might ever be hearing tapes of those?
I there's always possibility. I mean, I think that anyone who speaks to Donald Trump should be certainly switching on their iPhone to tape what's going on here. I think everybody knows that lesson. But the other thing, and why this becomes this will be somewhat of a difficult thing to prosecute is that Donald Trump is always on the phone. Donald Trump is always talking. Donald Trump is only half aware of what he's saying. It just spews out. There is no rhyme nor reason to it. He talks, I mean, the Georgia phone call lasted, I can't quite remember, but it certainly lasted for close to an hour of him just repeating repetition upon repetition. Him going out of the lines and the boundaries of any logic. There were certain people on that call who are relatively astute politicians. Mark Meadows, for one thing. I mean, he's highly conservative, and whatever you think of him, you may politically disagree with him, but he is certainly a professional, a political professional. What was he doing on this call? And the only conclusion that I can come to is that all of these people are so used to Donald Trump just spewing meaningless, semi-deranged things that no one really takes this seriously. And I think that's what the result here, why this is going to be hard to prosecute, is it's just the rantings of a crazy man.